Good morning, my name is Father Ayappa. I'm in Bhutan, Puan Soling, in the bordering India. And I'm here in the heart of the city, this beautiful temple, Buddhist temple. And I'm going to talk about Laudato Si in this context, what Pope is talking about. The people of Bhutan, they live very happy life. And they believe their future is blessed because they don't exploit resources. They always have in their mind the future generations. They use resources sustainably so that the other people, those who come after them, also can use them. So that is called sustainable development. I think Bhutan is a very good example for that. So Pope is writing about it, about the happy future and the need to reduce our carbon footprint. He's talking in Laudato Si, in the paragraph number 113. I'm going to read it for you. Please listen carefully. Pope Francis, in Laudato Si, under the paragraph number 113, writes as follows. There is also the fact that people no longer seem to believe in a happy future. They no longer have blind trust in a better tomorrow based on the present state of the world and our technical abilities. There is a growing awareness that scientific and technological progress cannot be equated with the progress of humanity and history. A growing sense that the way to a better future lies elsewhere. This is not to reject the possibilities which technology continues to offer us, but humanity has changed profoundly, and the accumulation of constant novelties exalts a superficiality which pulls us in one direction. It becomes difficult to pause and recover depth in life. If architecture reflects the spirit of an age, our megastructures and drab apartment blocks express the spirit of globalized technology, where a constant flood of new products coexist with a tedious monotony. Let us refuse to resign ourselves to this and continue to wonder about the purpose and meaning of everything. Otherwise, we would simply legitimate the present situation and need new forms of escapism to help us endure the emptiness. Wow. Other countries, they show importance to technology and consumption, and they think technology is the essence of life. That is a delusion. That's what Pope says in the encyclical. So Bhutan people, they live with the environment. They don't have too much of technology. They have nature and the environment, and they enjoy happiness, peace and joy. And they don't value GDP as other countries, their neighbors India and China do. They talk about GDP 9%, 10%, 11%, but Bhutan talks only about happiness. Their gross domestic product is happiness and peace and joy, nothing else. Not in monetary terms, it is an integral human development. That is what Pope is writing in Laudato Si, in the paragraph number 113. And I am in Bhutan. It's a beautiful country. It's a paradise on earth. It is a role model for the rest of the world. 200 countries should have humility and simplicity to learn from this sustainable country on the face of the earth. And thank you. God bless. Laudato Si, please.